that God chose now to give you to us. God chose now to give you to me. Who am I? Who am I that I would go from Zion, go free from the never-ending sacrifice of thanks for my sin? How are you?
Like a drum was loaded, the curtain was open, my Lord. Be glad that Jesus has come.
Amen.
About 6 months ago, seems like a long time ago when we started working on this, from the very outset, we said as a worship ministry, we wanted the point of this not to be, look what we can do, or how big of a production can we put on, but we wanted to point people to Jesus Christ. And I hope that it's something that you've seen on the stage tonight, that you've seen Jesus Christ, the real reason for Christmas. It would also be incredibly assumptuous of me to assume that everyone in this room is a Christian. If you're here this morning and you don't know Jesus Christ as your Savior, please come and talk to me. We'll talk to one of these guys. We'll be hanging out in front at the end. We want a chance to lead you to Him. He really is the reason for Christmas. And God gave the greatest Christmas gift that He could have given when He sent Jesus to earth. Not just to be born in a manger. Everybody likes that part of the story. But you see, as an adult, He was sentenced to die on the cross. And 3 days later, He rose again so that we could have a chance at eternal life if we would just accept Him. And I hope that if you don't know Jesus, that you won't leave here today without finding Him. Would you pray with me? Father, we love you so much. God, I pray right now that You would speak to those hearts that maybe in this room that don't know You, that they would realize their need for a Savior. They need to accept this gift of salvation that You gave us. And right now I pray that in all of our hearts that we would keep You at the center of this holiday season. That so many things can come and distract from family and friends to parties and all this other stuff. God, but it's all about You. Keep our focus on that. Lord, we love You. We praise You. We're so grateful for the gift that You gave us. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Didn't they do an incredible job? Not only did it sound good, it looked great too. Y'all just did an incredible job. Guys up there with the lights, I know many folks backstage, and there's folks that think Chris wants to thank, but you really did. It's a superb job sharing with us the true meaning of Christmas. So, Chris, are there some folks that you would like to thank?
First of all, the entire choir crew and cast. These guys worked really hard. Secondly, there are a few individuals that have really gone above and beyond. The first, which is Michelle Corvino. I think these sets, she designed, her and her family, they put them together. And it just, we put it up last week. I couldn't believe how great it was. So thank you, Michelle. I appreciate that. The next person is our assistant director, Kimberly Taylor. She's spent a long time with her own crew, helping to put that part of the production together. She knows a whole lot about that than I do, so I'm grateful to have her on board. Thank you very much, Kimberly. Trevor, you got off easy first service. Come here. Trevor was our technical director, overseeing all the lights, sound. Did a great job. I appreciate your hard work. Chris, didn't you do a great job as well? You know, all of you can see the visual fans pointing the bell, and they stop at the perfect time. I mean, that's a great job, Chris. All great job.
I do have some some reminder announcements that we gave you at the beginning, but also a few extras. This afternoon, Rob and Jackie Jones, Rob,